Hello again, my name is David Watts from Lenovo Press, and I have with me today Russ Resnick. He is the Worldwide Segment Manager for 1 and 2 socket rack mount servers.
Yes.
How are you doing today?
Great, glad to be here.
Okay, so today we're going to be talking about the ThinkSystem SR650. This is our new 2U, two-socket server in our ThinkSystem portfolio. So Russ, tell us about this system. And what's the sort of audience, the sort of customer that would use this system?
So this 2U system is really very flexible and is used by a variety of customers in lots of workloads, varied workloads, and seems to be the most popular in the industry for server form factors.
The system, being a 2U, very flexible in terms of drive bay configurations and slots, very versatile configuration choices.
Yes.
Right? Yep. All right, mm-hmm. So let's go through the front of the system and look at the back and then go from there, shall we?
Sure.
Yep, very good. So this particular system we have here is our 2.5-inch model. You can see here, if you do a quick count, you'll see we have space here for 24 drive bays at the front in the 2.5-inch form factor. We also have here our 3.5-inch model. This particular configuration supports up to 8 3.5-inch drive bays, but Russ, this server
will support up to 14.
Right,
3.5-inch drives.
12 at the front, 12.5 hot swap at the front,
and 2 in the rear.
And 2 more in the rear. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So a lot of versatile choices here. This system here with the 24 2.5s is also available in a 16 or an 8
or none.
Or none, if you mm-hmm. want to start from there. Yep. And both of these systems support any bay. Drive bays.
Correct.
Now, any bay. What's any bay, Russ?
So any bay is our bay that supports both. Or SAS, SATA, and NVMe drives in the 2.5-inch form factor.
So NVMe is a great drive choice if you're looking for ultra-low latency solid-state drives. It's excellent for high-speed IO mm-hmm. performance there. Yep. Now, along the front of these systems as well, on my side is the Vga port. That's an optional choice. You can choose to have that if you wish. And on the other side, the other ear, we have two USB ports. One is a USB 3, that's the top one, and one is a USB, sorry, I should say, bottom one is a USB 3, and the top one is a USB 2. Now, the USB 2 doubles as the USB port for the X-Clarity controller. That's our service processor. Now, Russ, what's the value of that USB port for X-Clarity controller?
I'm glad you asked me that. The reason we chose a USB port versus wireless is so that a customer can be certain that they're really using the X-Clarity controller in the server that they mean to.
Yep.
We want to make sure that there's no inadvertent configuration changes or reboots of a server that might be in production when someone's working on the system.
So you would use this port and this function if you have a phone or a tablet running the X-Clarity app. You connect the device through the USB port, through a cable, and that allows you to do local management directly from your device. Very easy way to connect, and with the cable ensuring you're talking to the right system.
Correct.
Yep. Now, as well as those two ports, we also have power button, an LED, various other system LEDs, and an ID button. The ID button is a blue LED that also, when you press it, activates an LED. Matching LED at the back of the system. That allows you to identify which system you're working on. You don't mess with the wrong one.
Correct.
Yeah. And you can also activate that ID button remotely through the X-Clarity controller or a Clarity administrator. So those are all the back components. That's the front components.
Yes.
Let's spin it around to the back and have a look at what we have.
Okay,
back there.
Great.
Okay, so we have here the power supply choices and I/O slots. This server supports up to 7. This is 6 slots at the back, rear.
Correct.
Accessible, as well as the LOM slot. We'll get to in a moment. And there's an internal storage slot
rear
as well
slot,
inside. There's a variety of lane widths by 8 by 16, and some are full height and some are slimline slots. We support two GPUs in
the
system.
That's correct.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So very versatile in that regard too. Now, as well as that, we have this component down here. This is called the LOM. Russ, tell me about that.
This is LAN on motherboard. So what we do is we offer a choice to our customers of 1 and 10 gig networking. So you can have two ports of 1 gig, two ports of 10 gig, four ports of 1 gig, four ports of 10 gig, which allows you to just purchase the networking you need for your configuration.
Very versatile choices there. Now, next to the LOM adapter, we also have a the dedicated RJ45. That's for
the management port.
Systems management, yes. Back to the X-Clarity controller again. The rear VGA port, two USB 3 connectors there. Next to that is a little pinhole for an NMI reset. This server also supports a serial port if you wish to install
through,
it.
Through an option?
Yeah, through an option, and then next to that is two bays for power supplies. These would be hot swap. If you install two, these would be redundant pair. So the capacities of the power supplies?
750, 1100, and 1600 watts.
Yep. So a variety of choices there, depending on the workload you have and how much power your system actually needs. So a lot of choices there too. Yeah. Now, this is a two socket system. The riser over here with the two bays, that's accessible when you have the second processor installed. The other slots are available on both single socket and two socket systems. All right, so that I think is the back there. Shall we open this up and have a look inside?
Let's do it.
So this is our new system running the new Intel Xeon processor, scalable family CPUs, right?
Yes.
Yep. Let me remove the air baffle there. I'll put that over here.
Okay.
So the server supports two sockets, two processors, each with 12 DIMMs, right?
That's correct.
Yep, for a total of 24 DIMMs. So now, if you're using, for example, the 64 gig LR DIMMs, then that's up to a total of 1.5 terabytes of RAM.
That's right.
Just for example. So suitable for applications with a large memory footprint. Very versatile system as a result. Let's see, let me remove this air baffle here. You can see here when I remove that, this gives us access to the LOM adapter. You can see there how it's plugged in. Now, these are two of the riser cards. Russ, you want to... Let's look over to that system there. There's some interesting things there to point out. This is the riser card for the system, one of the two choices. Two slot in this case. There are other riser slots available, including ones that you would use for double-wide GPUs.
That's
right?
Correct.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Now, also under this riser is the M.2 adapter slot here. This one here we have installed is the single M.2 adapter, and it has one M.2 drive on it. And let me show you here. This is the dual M.2 adapter, and it's dual because it has two M.2 cards, one on either side.
Along with a hardware RAID controller.
Right. So that means that this can be configured as a RAID 1 pair. So we would recommend you put your operating system on this. But if one of the M.2 cards fails, the system is still fully operational.
That's right.
Running off the other one. So this is an excellent choice for redundancy. Now, next to that, this is the RAID card that we use for some of these configurations. This is the RAID 530i adapter. Yep. Mm-hmm. So it has eight SAS or SATA ports. The one over here, I'm referring on this system here, this one here, because it has the 24 drives on the front, this adapter here is the RAID
24i. This is a 24-port RAID card.
So the variety, these systems support a variety of RAID adapters and internal HBAs to support whichever drive configuration you have. I would add, by the way, when you do have the 3.5-inch model with 12 bays at the front and you have the two drive bays at the back, then it's this riser here that replaces
replaced with those drives.
Right, that's where those two rear mount drive bays go. Yeah.
The other thing I want to point out is these 8-bay backplanes here are all modular. So the customer has a choice between how many 8-bay backplanes. And we also have an 8-bay backplane, which isn't shown here, which is one of the 8-bay any-bay backplanes.
Right.
Which is four ports of SAS SATA and four ports.
Now, where do those connect to?
So those will connect to these two ports of NVMe.
Right. So the any bay backplane, which supports, supports NVMe as well as SAS and SATA, you connect the SAS SATA ports to a suitable RAID card, and you connect the NVMe ports directly to those onboard pair of by 8 connectors there.
That's correct.
Yeah. Okay. So I think that's about it, Russ. We want to talk about servicing of the system, right?
Yeah. So this system has been designed, from the ground up to be easily serviceable. As you can see, all the blue touch points are really designed for service. So there's a handle here to get the board out. There's also a screw here, and then of course these two blue touch points here allow you to take the fan cage out.
Yeah.
All at once.
I would point out too, Russ, that the fan cage you pulled out, if you have a failed fan, mm-hmm. these fans themselves, individual fans, are hot swap. So you can remove these while the system is running to replace a fan unit if necessary.
That's right.
Yeah. The orange gives away the fact that this is hot swap. The blue color on the board indicates components that you can remove once the system is powered off.
That's right.
Your touch points. Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right. So there you have it. Russ, do we have anything else to cover here?
No, I think we covered it all.
Very good. So there you have it. This is the SR650. This is our new 2U, two-socket server from Lenovo. Russ, if people want to learn more about the system?
You can check the link on YouTube, or you can go to lenovopress.com for the product guide.
Yep. So there you have it. Hope you found the video useful, and we will see you later.
Thank you very much.